See, there are still things which parents can't do but a guru can do. There's a difference. Why guru is given a position as big as the parents? Parents cannot, you know, the many, many things. There is not only just one thing. If we write down the attributes of a guru in our lives, they are countless. They are just countless. First thing, he studies our past. Even if we don't study ourselves, he studies our past. Out of A, B, C, D, how much we have learnt in the past lives? Up to F, up to M, up to Z, whatever. But he will first try to understand how much you know about life. And from then onwards, he will start teaching you. Parents won't do this. Guru will increase your capacity to hold the knowledge. Nobody else will do it. Then he will pour the knowledge, say like this, and the utensil, whatever your, you will be full of the next dose of the knowledge. Then again Guru will expand your capacity. Then again pour more. See, nobody is doing this much effort to improve you, to take you to those heights, to fulfill your dreams. And Guru has only one dream, that you fulfill your dream. That's all. He doesn't have his own dream. His dream is your dream. There are no two dreams. Whatever he knows, he offers you without expectations. No. And creates the capacity, puts you amongst the whole wisdom he has learnt, not only from scriptures, but also from his gurus. So whatever he is speaking to you, he is speaking from his gurus, mind it, in all the 50 or 60 years of his life. Whatever he was taught, he is passing it to you. And now put one question again here and you will find many, many answers. From where this seed you got, from where it came to you? From some tree. And from where that tree came? From some another tree. Or then you go back, some old tree and some old seed and some old seed and some old seed, finally where you reach at the beginning of the universe. When we all think alike, when we all think in the past and we regress from where we are coming, from where my father came, from my, his father came, from his father and like this, if we go on regressing and looking at the life, we all reach at the same place. That's where Krishna says, Mamevanchu jiyu loke. I am present in everyone. Everybody is having, say, part of me. Or I am part of the whole world. Nobody is without me. This you can experience at this place. And it's not so simple. It's not so simple. When you look at the dimensions of the body, of the intellect, or of the mind, heart, there are many, many, many. Everyone has his or her own dimensions of life. And no two persons are alike. No two persons are alike. No. Then, all the knowledge we are getting from the school, colleges, internet, television, media, whatever, books, is all coming from outside. It is my borrowed knowledge. It doesn't belong to me. When you are in trouble, no book will help you on this earth. No Puran, no Ved, no Shastra will help you. No. Then who will help you? The Guru, the wisdom of the Guru moving in your own body. That will give you what is called wisdom, not information, not knowledge. It is wisdom. We call pragya. Pragya kisko bolte hain? Ritambara tatra pragya. Something which can see the invisible. Rit. Rit means which has no form, formless. And if something which can see the invisible, the formless, that is it. That means pragya. That means this capacity to see this invisible is the main task of the Guru. No teacher, no parents on this earth can teach you how to feel the invisible, how to live in the invisible, how to understand the invisible inside you. If you don't understand the invisible working inside you, you don't understand yourself. No chance. Then the purpose of your life is not complete. Maybe you take birth 4 times, 10 times. No, not possible. That invisible Guru inside will teach you about the invisible world, will make that connection between the two invisible potentials, powers, or the areas of the wisdom. Without that, we can't understand this. Because all these pranas are, again I said, devas. Devas means the cosmic, or larger I will say solar. From the solar zone, all the energies available in that zone is known as devas. We call them pranas inside. And gurus and parents, they all work like pranas. And we know, my father or anybody's father, he contains in his seed the portions from 7 male generations. How the cosmic life works inside us. Sometimes we say he behaves like father, he behaves like grandfather or great-grandfather, but it is because of those strengths. And same way, the female works in the body, there's 7 generations of females from mother to grandmother to grandmother, or great-grandmother, likewise. So now you see the dimension in my life, the complexity of my life or this body is not that simple. If I want to understand the 7th generation of my father, I can't even imagine. But it is the Guru which travels with you in the prana shape. And his interest is to convert you into a Guru. Who will do this other than him? I don't know. I have not seen anybody that who wants to transform you. It is only Guru who will be happy on that day when you become like him. Then you see, can we imagine the importance of Guru somewhere? Can we place him this way? Who else will try to bring you to that level? Everybody tries to push you away. But it's only the Guru who converts you like him. His dream is to make you like Guru. But see, he is now 60. Disciples are now 40. 35, in 40, he will make you like himself. Then you have another 40 years to grow further, which nobody can even follow. I say, if you can understand this fact, you can shape your life by having control on all invisible forces inside you. Without that, it is really not possible. Really not possible. Guru has many, many more meanings. Not one or two meanings. Guru has, I think, my experience is, Guru works more for you than you work yourself. Why I like a Guru, why I respect a Guru, is only because of this one reason. That he works for me more than myself. I may be proud of my own work or hard work, whatever you call it, but no, I know that I don't work that much. I have seen my Guru working for me, and in my life I cannot forget that scene. That every morning he will get up, he will prepare himself to teach me. Can you believe it? It's very difficult to follow that a Guru prepares himself to teach the disciple every day. What does it mean? There is a sutra, a shloka, or a verse in which the Guru wants to teach you today. And he knows you cannot understand this. He will try to digest that verse in his intellect. You've seen the bee working on the pollens of the flowers. What it does? It digests everything and creates honey. And honey is only one product on this earth which you need not digest. It is automatically digested and it is always sweet. This is the task of the Guru. He will make all complex knowledge, wisdom. He will digest himself, bring it to that level where I can follow the real meaning behind it. What is the intention behind this verse? What it wants to tell me about my life? It is very difficult because he knows I have learnt up to M or N or R, whatever. He will digest that wisdom to that level. For one person he will digest up to E level, for another person up to R level, for another up to P level. For 20 students, he has 20 levels of the same verse. He will digest and teach each one at his or her level, like a honey. He will distribute honey which each one can digest. You know, in India we call madhu. Honey means madhu. All other sweets are known as madhur, except honey. Because that R in the end is symbol of fire. That means everything else needs to be digested, not honey. And Guru serves us with honey, not with sweets. We don't need to digest it. He digests it before serving us. If we put that picture before us, I think then we know how much he works for us. No. Today we are sitting for 2 hours. And I know only about 2 hours, but I don't know about another 2 hours he was sitting in the morning and looking, preparing himself what he will teach me today for 2 hours. He will be working maybe for 4 hours to teach me for 2 hours. So I think it is our education system has never taught us how to respect our own gurus because no teacher has shown the personal affiliation, affections, concerns about my life. The teacher will come, talk about the subject and say bye-bye. Period is over. No, Guru knows. He knows that there are 20 people, have 20 different aspects of life. He will live like it, he will live like another one. What is the future of this person, this person, this person? Accordingly, he will teach each individual. He cannot teach like a factory, you know, the whole school is run and every product or every student is like the same. No, not possible. With a guru, not possible. Provided you have the faith in your guru. If you have faith, You are the future guru. There is no doubt about it. This is my guarantee, I can give you. If you have faith in your guru, you are the future guru. There is no doubt. And you will create more gurus. As we say, I am Brahmasmi. And Ekam Bahu Sham. I am one, but I want to create many. Guru is the symbol of Brahma in that respect. He creates many gurus in his life, provided people have faith in him. And then again, everyone further, like the tree, creates many, many. Each tree creates many, many mangoes from one seed. From one guru, you have many disciples. And from each disciple, there are further many more. So I think if we have a vision, that is the message from the guru, that is where we are. And in the end, you also become part of his, part of him, he becomes part of you. There is no difference between the disciple and the guru, both are same. That is the, you can say, area or the main aim of life. So both of you, the guru and disciple, can live in the sannyas ashram, last 25 years of the life, in peace and in service to the people, to the God. Hari Om.
Thank you, Gulabji. Very beautiful, very nicely explained. The subject of what means the Guru, what means the Mother, Father, Devas. For that we thank our Gulabji. Yes, that's true what he said. That Guru works for us more than anyone works for us in their life. Guru is that one who, Gulabji said, that bee which collects the taste from all kinds of flowers, bitter, poisonous, sweetest, best, all the blossoms of different plants and digests in its own stomach, turns into the nectar, honey, and gives us. Similarly, as he said, the life of the master is that which is working 24 hours for the disciples without expectations, experiencing the different situation of the life, but constantly producing that nectar of the wisdom for what we call the liberation. That we are able, capable to talk ourself to ourself. What a wonder, what a funny thing, that self is searching self. No, Gulabji?
Yes.
That's a very interesting subject for us next time. Self is searching self. And as we go back and one seed to the other seed and other seed, very interesting subject in the whole world and in every culture. Simply they said, what was the first, chicken or the egg? You know? Tree or the fruit? Mother or the father? So there is the answer, as he said in one word, the Guru is everything, he is a father and mother. It is that creator as a Brahma, which is creating in us feelings, wisdom, inspirations, motivations and whatever we call, is the Vishnu which is protecting us from kushangas or whatever the things, and concentrating and constantly supplying us that nectar. And he is that Shiva, Mahesh, which is destroying all the negative qualities and liberation, the liberating. Finally, the Gulabji finishes his explanation, liberation. So life ratios, liberation, L, the life ration is the ratios. That as in beginning he told, the layer after the layer, 7 generations past is very active in us. Good, we understand our life. May we understand our father and grandfather, but who was your 7th grandfather? Do you know the name? So even we don't know the name. How was he and she? And what you do, that was very important. Thank you, Gulabji. That what you do will influence the 7th one also in the past. So 7 past, past and 7 future. So we are in between. 7 and 7 is 14, and that's why the moon phases is after 14 days changing. Thank you. Something became very clear, and that I understood also what you said, that my Gurudev, our Holy Guruji, 18 hours he was meditating and making his mantras and malas, and when people asked, Swamiji, you are now so old and you have achieved maybe everything, for what you are doing malas? He says, I am not doing for me, I am doing for my disciples. I am doing for my disciples. And the same feelings I have, I am not a guru, I am still a disciple. But I am traveling, taking so many journeys, so many things. For what? Because I am committed to deliver that nectar which I collected from my master to distribute to my disciples. And that's a very great point. Thank you. I have to develop this now, Gulabji. If you have faith or that devotion to your guru, be sure. He said that he will give in return. I want yes tomorrow in return, please. Thank you. That you are the future guru. And that's how we declare from the dynasty to dynasty, known as a successor. That true? Okay? See you, dear brothers and sisters around the world, and wish you all the best and very good evening. Thank you. God bless you. Deepnan Bhagwan ki. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.